Good morning and welcome to a new Technoware webinar. My name is Maurizio Controzzi. I'm the Technoware CEO for EMEA area, including Europe, Africa, and Middle East. Today the topic is server and data center protection using UPS systems. We will see some interesting statistics and we will explain you how and why to use UPS system and which model you can select to match all your requests. After the webinar, please feel free to make any kind of question. Today with me there is the engineer, Mr. Marco Auletta from the technical department that will support me to give you this, to give you technical information in details. So let's start. First of all, let's see what does data center and server mean. All data centers are essentially buildings or dedicated rooms that provide space, power, and cooling for network infrastructure. The server is a computer program or device that provides functionality for other programs or devices, called also clients. The complete architecture is called the client-server model, and the single overall computation is distributed across multiple process or devices. Server can provide various functionalities, often called services, such as sharing data or resources among multiple clients or performing computation for a client. A single server can serve multiple clients, and a single client can use multiple servers. A client process may run on the same device or may connect over a network to a server on a different device. Typical servers are database servers, file servers, mail servers, print servers, web, game, and other application servers. Client server systems are today most frequently implemented by often identified with the request response model. A client sends a request to the server which performs some action and sends a response back to the client, typically with a result or acknowledgement. Let's see some global trends and statistics. Statistics say that during the period 2019-2023, the data center server market will worth $56 billion. It is estimated that there are around 6,000 data centers worldwide with 90 million square feet of space. Or in more familiar terms, that's enough data center space in the world to fit more than 6,000 football fields. In 2019, global server market revenue grew to $33.6 billion, with a growth estimation of 16.5% for 2020. Around 3 million servers shipped in 2019, with a growth estimation of 12% for 2020. So, as you can see, this market is keeping growing year by year. So, let's see the protection. Next page. Cambia. Okay, so data center and server protection 4.0 using UPS systems. First of all, what is an UPS? This is a very important question, and we know that an UPS, called also interruptible power supply, is a device that in case of blackout still supply power to your connected equipment through one or more internal battery for a limited time. Which device and why I have to connect the data center and server to the UPS? It's important to use UPS to connect the whole data center system, avoiding any data lost, downtime, and disconnection in case of blackout. And it's also very important to connect all server-centered systems, avoiding any data lost, downtime, and disconnection in case of blackout. Why and what I have to connect to the UPS to protect data centers, devices, and servers. Now we will go in details to see how and what we have to protect using UPS system. And Mr. Marco Auletta will give you such information. Please.
Okay, thank you very much, Maurizio. Good morning to everybody. Thank you very much to be here. Okay, now we start to see the technical point of view of this webinar. And we start to see how we need to protect UPS server data centers. In every company, it is essential to protect the server of data center from blackout, power surge, and any type of electrical problem. Ordinary and extraordinary events to the power lines can damage the device, which could stop the functionality. In more serious cases, there is the loss of data for the continuous or the working activity. Protecting server or data center with a suitable UPS, such as the Evo DSP Plus with online technology, means protecting the operation even when not physically present in the company, guaranteeing the protection of the data contained in the devices during exceptional event or in everyday use. Now we see some UPS characteristics about the online technology and online type of UPS. The first is the maximum power quality, even the event of a blackout, supplying energy purified from grid disturbances thanks to the online double conversion technology. They are equipped with advanced software for the management of the orderly shutdown of the operating system event or virtualized machines if the UPS had run out of autonomy as a result for a prolonged blackout. Safe control and restart when the power returns. Tech management software for remote monitoring and detection and warning of UPS status. Complete integration with the ABMS system, thanks to the multiple communication interfaces with clean contact, Modbus, or USB serial, or via network IP SMB. Configurable for a long autonomy according to the need, total compatibility with generators in the event of a blackout, very high reliability based on most modern construction technologies. Why we need to protect data centers and server? Now we need to first we need to make a consideration. The electrical network can be subject to several disturbances, which are more and frequent, and also are they are much varied that you might think. These are the possible phenomena. The most famous is the blackout, the electricity main interruption. Then we have the under voltage over voltage, can be standard or dynamic. The difference is the time that the event request, if is rapid, is a dynamic. If you have this for some time, is a standard situation. Also, we have the lightning that requests UPS plus upstream arrested. It is a high intensity atmospheric electrical discharge, for example, the lightning. The voltage surge is a sudden increase in electrical voltage with voltage peak. The frequency variation, the variation in frequency, distortion in voltage for a short periods, and the harmonic disturbance that is a frequency component and distortion on the input voltage. Why to choose an online UPS? The online technology is identified with the initial VFI, voltage and frequency independent. This technology is commonly called double conversion. During operations, it means the UPS output is filled through the rectifier, which converts the UPS input voltage from alternated to continuous voltage in conjunction with the inverter that transform again the continuous voltage into alternated voltage. This system permits to output voltage to be perfectly sinusoidal, clean, and very stable in voltage and frequency, apart from the problems present in the main. For this, we can determine that the transfer time of an online UPS is zero. Therefore, it's only the online UPS that guarantees maximum safety for the devices to be protected, as in addition to guaranteeing no interruption, there also is a separation system, the double conversion that blocks the problem of the electricity mains to protect the server or data center. Now we see why it is more important to use an online UPS. It's more important because data center requests, in addition, log autonomy and action event records. The log autonomy can be managed with the UPS only, and in these cases, the autonomy is guaranteed with a not exceeding battery number. Now, then we see why. Or the combination UPS plus generator that is the most preferable and also the most present. The action events report can be managed with different communication methods, as via network mail, contact, or through other different interfaces. About log autonomy, we said that we have two kinds of system. UPS only, the autonomy is totally dependent by the battery bank associated to the UPS. However, this kind of management has technical, economic, and space limits. More will be the power that we need to support, more will are the limits because an expensive number of batteries will determine its installation not technically optimized, and the investment and maintenance cost will become expensive. Also, the phase that the battery would require is usually difficult to obtain. The second way, UPS plus generator combination, is preferable because the combination then allows to obtain long autonomy because the operating time will be the summation of the autonomy of the battery containing UPS, especially by the capacity of generator's tank. The UPS will take care of ensuring the continuity of the power supply, while the generator will start to supply energy to replace the electricity grid. The number of batteries will be proportionate to cover this work for a few minutes or for the time that you need to refuel the generator. Now we see why it is important to use online UPS. The compatibility of the UPS with the generator is only possible with online UPS because the generator generates in a stable frequency. Therefore, the use of a non-online UPS will cause the non-synchronization of the power supply network. UPS Online is the only one technology that is independent of the grid frequency, as we can see and we can saw before. About communication interfaces, we have two kinds of communication: dry contacts, SNMP, and Modbus. The dry contacts provide a set of relay contacts able to identify UPS alarm status and battery mode, as battery mode, discharge, battery, active bypass, or general alarm. With it is possible to manage audible and visible alert. The SNMP interface enables connection and configuration of the UPS in a LAN computer network, and in data centers you have always a LAN connection network, and it is for this that this kind of communication is the preferable and the most used in this application. Each SNMP interface provides the necessary software for the monitoring and management of the UPS by LAN, compatible with most operating systems. With it is possible also to receive mail alert message with advice about what happened to UPS and protect the device in real time, because in data centers it is difficult, there is someone that check physically the situation. The Modbus RS485 interface allow UPS and PC connection through the Modbus protocol. This kind of protocol is most used in complex building, and it is used when you would like to have only one logic control of every devices, not only UPS, not only data centers, with only one program as reference. because this is an international protocol for every devices. Now we see our technical EVDSP range in IT efficiency that we offer to protect 7 data centers. We start with the little model 1 kVA up to the 300 kVA power. So we cover the different range and request. For a single application, for example, we suggest the the EVDSP plus that start from 1.2 up to 3.6 kVA in rack tower format, because you can see you can know the single server can be a tower PC or PC in rack installation. So in this mode you can integrate UPS in the same system with the same configuration. And for the multiple devices protection, we offer the model from 6 to 300 kVA in single phase, three phase, and also three phase input, single phase output. About the first model, the in little power, the rack tower EVDSP plus from 1.2 up to 3.6 kVA. We can have back time up to 30 minutes. We can also extend the autonomy with the external battery box for the bigger model. The system it is with Oslo battery, power factor 0.9. This is power factor is every the same for every hour UPS online. The only difference for modular UPS where the power factor is 1. You have a multifunctional display that is rotable to put it in the same position respect to the UPS installation, and it is compatible with our software, and with you can install the various interfaces that we saw before. These are a focus. This is a focus on the rear side of our UPS. And another information that is very important about this application is that our UPS are compatible with generators. So for the installation, you not need to put you not need to make any configuration of the UPS. The UPS is ready to work with generators. Also, if you want, you can open the input frequency range to to have a big range of acceptance and input about by the UPS. In this configuration is called computer frequency mode. Now we see the model single phase from 6 up to 10 kVA. And also here you can extend autonomy. Each battery box has its independent battery charger. So in this mode, you can, in theory, install infinity battery box. But then, for the reason that we saw before, you need a limit for space for technical point of view and also for money. An active PFC active circuits, the IPO contact for the emergency power off. You can change frequency and voltage depending which is your application, and then you have static and manual bypass. The static for to avoid the interruption about the service if you have a damaged UPS, the manual bypass for the maintenance. They are the same focus to respect this kind of power. Then we have the Aura Modular UPS. This is the most technology and the most or the better solution for data centers, especially for data centers where you have very important and very big quantity of data, because the kind of server is the kind of UPS system is the most safety, and because it has an swap design. Power and module and battery modules are with a scalable system. This is a flexible design, and for about parallel, you can have redundant system plus one and one n plus x. And also, you can put one or more power module in reserve configuration. For this, you can have a no downtime system, and in any case of issue, the UPS automatically prepare it, and so with this way you can change the problem also in a second time, and you cannot see the difference respect the situation before the damage. Also, we have our standalone UPS from 10 up to 200 kVA. Also, here the high efficiency, the power factor 0.9, the HIPPO contact, static and manual bypass, and the choice also to expand our UPS in parallel redundancy configuration up to 3 units for the model from 10 to 80 kVA and 2 units from 100 up to 200 kVA standalone version. These are the various focus on the various power. Also, for them, every are compatible with generators without any configuration. And you can see our range. And here you can see the touch LCD display, the same of modular UPS, where you can see every information, a very high quantity of information. And also, you can set various configuration of the UPS. It is very important also to say that this kind of UPS from 100 kVA up to 200 kVA are in a modular design, but are not modular UPS. But we decide to make this kind of construction of building of this UPS because it is important also to have a little safety when you have a big power to manage. Thank you very much for your participation. Here you can see our services. You can see our contact for every info, qualification that you can have to send the mail. And now we reply some answers that arrive from your side.
Thank you, Marco. So we don't have a lot of time left. Anyway, there are many people and many questions are coming. So we will reply to some of you. Let's pick up some questions that can be interesting for most of you. For example, people are asking about the warranty, about where to buy, or some technical request. Let's start with about warranty. Warranty, of course, it depends on which product we are talking about. Every product has got different warranty, can be up to 5 years. And in case you receive an offer or request or configuration, every time you will also receive the warranty specified for each product. About where to buy, we are present in more than 40 countries worldwide, so you can contact directly our distributor, our partners, or Tecnoware, and we will give you full details. Our customers and distributors, system integrator are always very specialized and professionalists, so they can give you full technical and commercial support, including configuration and including support you during tender or project checking all the specification. About there is one technical request. You already say that, but people are asking Marco if our UPS are compatible with generators.
Yes, they are compatible. As I said, our UPS has a large range on the input for 50 and 60 hertz. With a generator, you not need to do any configuration because this range is bigger respect to the generator various frequency that it can generate. But if you have a situation where the generator is very unstable, you can also open the input frequency range for 50 and 60 hertz in the same moment with the computer frequency mode, where you can have a frequency from 40 to 70 hertz in input, and the output you can generate the 50 or 60 hertz, you can choose it. And this mode you can also give the correct solution and the correct voltage frequency to your devices, in this case, server and data centers.
And it's very important to know that Tecnoware UPS are compatible with all generators, and you don't have to do any setup or reset. You just install the product, it's ready. Another question is about batteries. Which kind of battery Tecnoware use? I can reply telling you that you use standard batteries, so lead acid batteries. And then depends, of course. We use a battery from 5 ampere hour up to 200 ampere hours. It depends on the products and the configuration required. Another question is about the backup time. Very quickly, I think you can reply. People are asking if we can give up to 1 hour of backup time. Marco, you can reply if you want.
Yes, as I reported before, very easily, our UPS in theory can have infinite battery box for extended autonomy because they have its independent charger. So you can have also more than 1 hour, 2 hours. Yes, then we need to evaluate the configuration about a technical point of view. For this, it's preferable when you have a very long autonomy time, not use only battery because then you have to manage them in the future, but use an autonomy that you can choose, 1 hour, for example, and then go ahead for other hours with the generator. These are our suggestions.
Okay.
Battery is possible.
Okay, let's take another question, then we have to close the webinar. People are asking if our UPS are suitable for hospital or electrical medical equipment. I can reply telling you that yes, our UPSs are suitable. You can have all the accessories required in this kind of solution, like isolation transformer, for example. We have got all the certification, so you can easily offer our products to this kind of for this kind of solution and request. Hospital, medical equipment, data center, server, enterprise, private and public. I'm still receiving some more questions, but the time is run out. Thanks for participating. Please feel free to contact us through our email or channels, social channels, and we will give you more details. If you are an end user, we can give you our distributor contacts, or if you would like to consider to distribute Tecnoe products, contact me and I will give you more details and we can discuss, of course. It's been a pleasure to have you, Marco. Thanks for your time.
Thank you,
Thanks
Victor.
for everyone to participate to this webinar. Next week, we got a new webinar coming about smart working protection 4.0. So it's very interesting and it's a big market increasing day by day, especially in this period where smart working solution demand is increasing a lot. And so thanks again for your time. Keep following Tecnoe through our social networks. More news are coming soon. Stay tuned, stay safe, and see you soon. Have a nice day. Thank you, Marco.
Thank you, Maurizio. Goodbye to everybody. Thank you very much.
Bye bye.